Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, we have a full moon coming up at the middle part of next week on the 22nd, 23rd. So we're going to have a lot of, I don't want to call it light pollution because the moon is not really light pollution, but it's artificial light that's going to wash out some of the things that we would normally be able to see that are fainter, like star clusters or galaxies or whatever else. So instead, we're going to focus on some double stars, which will sort of punch through that light. And I will start over in the northern part of the sky, because you can see the moon is going to be way over here. Here's where our center of our galaxy is starting to fade off below the horizon, at least here in the northern hemisphere, at 40 degrees north latitude where I'm located. But if we look towards the north, turn on our constellation markers and lines over in Cassiopeia. Here's the North Star. We can find that actually by going from the Big Dipper across. Cassiopeia is sort of this M or W shape. If we zoom in on that some, we got lots of stuff that's happening for deep sky objects, but we're going to take those off and not show those because we want to focus on some double stars. Here's our brighter stars within Cassiopeia. Beta is a 2.25, Alpha is a 2.2, Gamma is a 2.2. We get a little bit dimmer over here with 2.65 and then 3.35. So our brighter side of that, we're gonna focus on the middle star and then go towards Alpha. And see this star right in the middle? That's Eta Cassiopeiae. Don't get confused by these two double stars. We're going to focus on this one. You won't be able to see that as a double in a finder scope or in binoculars. You really will need to use some telescopic magnification on this. So if we center that and zoom in, what we find is that we can't really see a lot. So what do we have to do with stellarium? Well, click over on the sky viewing options window. And what you want to do is go to the sky tab and see the absolute scale and relative scale. Bring those down some, at least the relative scale. And then all of a sudden, oh, hey, look, there's our double star. Now, these are pretty cool because they're close. They're only about 19 light years away. There is a little bit of a difference in terms of the type and temperature of these stars. So our main one is an F-class star. It is therefore somewhat brighter, but our dimmer one, the Eta Cassiopeiae B, is, and I don't actually see it on there, but I believe it's a K-class star, so therefore it's quite a bit dimmer. But when you look at these through a telescope, you'll see a color difference. The question is, what color difference do you see? Because this star is quite a bit dimmer than A. See, A is 3.5. And this we're looking at 7.4. So due to that difference in magnitude, you may see some interesting color changes. So post that for me, whether you found me on Twitter or Facebook or follow on YouTube, post what colors you see when you look at those two stars. I know what I see, but tell me what you see through your telescope when you view that. So that's a really easy one to find because the distance between these two stars, not that far. You can find that right through any finder scope. You're looking at just 4.5 degrees or so. And Eta is not quite halfway in between there. So pretty simple to find. The harder one to find is on the other part of the sky towards the south. And that one you may want to wait for the moon to kind of get out of the way a little bit. So we're going to head over towards where the summer triangle is. I'm actually going to bring some of our relative scale back up so we can see some of this a little bit more easily. And we'll bump that out of the way. So here's where the Great Square of Pegasus is and then the Flying Horse's Nose. So if we go that direction and kind of shoot off that way towards the Summer Triangle, there's this little teeny tiny constellation over here called Delphinus, which is supposed to be a dolphin. So it's made up of pretty dim stars. It's like mostly fourth magnitude stars. As you can see, these are not bright stars at all. So if you cannot find this because of light pollution or the moon, I understand. But you're going to look about 15 degrees away from Enif, which is a second magnitude star. And some people may even be able to see this star right here, Gamma Sagittae. So look kind of halfway in between those. That's a 3.5 magnitude star. So you might be able to find that, or even just look for Altair and then just kind of go above there with a finder scope. And then these stars will kind of pop out fairly easily. The distance across these little ones right here, only 3 degrees, and even the entire thing is only about 5.5, 6 degrees across, so not very big as far as constellations. But what you want to aim for is that one, the one on the nose of the dolphin itself. I don't think it looks like a dolphin, but that's where you want to focus. So centering that, bringing our relative scale back down. And then zooming in, we can split these, boop, and there they go. So there's two stars. Now these ones are closer in magnitude to each other because we've got 4.3 and 5.1, so a little more balanced. And they're further away. These are about 100 light years away, but that's still kind of in our relative neighborhood, I guess you could say. But just interesting, the difference in what you see in terms of brightness for something that's, you know, only 20 light years away versus 100 light years away, and really comparable in kind of what you're seeing there. But tell me what you see with those two, and tell me if you can split those. Now, what I did was I just had a 70 millimeter refractor aimed at both of these. I was able to split both with just 50 times of magnification. I did bump it up to about 90 later on, just to kind of get a little bit more separation and see a little bit more color. So take a look at both of these stars with a small telescope, and tell me what colors that you see in these when you observe them. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.